Welcome to the course of control systems. In this course, we are going to deal with the control systems for linear time invariant systems, that too in continuous time. This is the first lecture of the course, and there will be a series of lectures followed by this lecture. In this lecture, we are going to discuss what exactly the system means, what is control systems, what are the objectives of control systems, and its classification. So let us start with the system. What exactly the system is? So system is nothing but the combination of components that are acting or performing together to perform the intended task. Let me write it so that you have a better understanding. It is a combination of components that act together to perform intended task. What does it mean? What is mean by component? Always, are the components physical only? The components can be physical, they can be in the form of hardware, they can be in the form of software. So software also form the system, and they act together, means they are joined together by some means as desired, and they perform the intended task. Means what? Certain task is assigned to that system, and that system performs that task. Correct. Let us see some examples of the systems, real life examples. Let us consider oven and this is the heater. This heater is fed with AC supply. So this one is oven and this one is heater. So these are the two components, and they are acting together for what? To maintain or to provide the heat to the environment inside this compartment. And we can maintain the temperature at certain desired value also, but then that will become the control system. Let us take one more example. Let there be a tank. And this tank has outlet. So this is the inlet flow, this one is the outlet flow, this one is the valve, the pipe, the tank. So many elements are acting together for what? To have storage of liquid inside the tank. So this is also a system. So different components acting together to perform the intended task. Now what is control system? So control system, let us say control system. It is a type of system. And the word control is coupled with the word system. That means there has to be control of some thing that we want. See, for example, let us revisit the same two systems. And say, for example, I want to maintain the temperature inside this oven at say 100 degree centigrade. So how can we do so? We can do so by providing the variable current through this coil. So the energy dissipated or power dissipated will be different, and that will keep the temperature at desired value. But now who will provide the variable current and who will decide what should be that variable current? Same way about here, we want to maintain this level at certain desired value. So by adjusting this wall position, we can do so. But who will do so? Who will decide at what value, at what position the wall shall be kept? So that will be done by the control system. And let us see in general the diagram of control system. So we have a controller and a system. And this is the output of the system. And this is input to the controller. What will be the input to the controller? That will be decided by the controller strategy. Whether it is open loop system, whether it is closed loop system, or it is something different. There are numerous control strategies and control schemes. So that will decide what this signal is. But this signal is control signal. And this is defined by u of t, output will be y of t. So in general, if it is a system, this controller will not be a part, and then the system block diagram will be only this much. So input will be control signal, output will be output, or that y of t. This output y of t in control system is referred as controlled variable. Now we are moving into the terminology of the control system, and this control signal or u of t is called as manipulated variable. So what is mean by controlled variable? Say for example, reconsider this example. We want temperature inside the oven at say 100 degree centigrade. So temperature inside the system becomes the controlled variable, which will be controlled. How? By adjusting the current to the heater. Then the current becomes manipulated variable. So which is the output of controller? This is the manipulated variable. Then next, why? With what objectives we are forming this control system? So there are numerous control objectives, but we will see two prime control objectives. With what objective, with what purpose we are doing it? So let this be time t, let this be output y of t, and we are going to see two different approaches. So I will sketch two graphs for y of t, and let this be the desired value of output, and let us say that we have two objectives. The one is tracking and the other is regulation. So what is tracking, what is regulation? Let us see. Let us consider that initially your value is here and you want it to be here. So the controller will take appropriate decision, and then the output will start moving towards the desired value, and it will track the output with certain dynamics like this. So this taking the output from initial condition to the desired value is called as tracking. And now let us consider another example where, say for example, your output is at desired value and suddenly there is a disturbance. example that can be, say, somebody comes and pours a bucket of water in the tank. That is a disturbance. So then the controller has to take action to bring it back to the desired value, and this is called as regulation. So regulation, in regulation, the output is already at the set point, but suddenly some disturbance comes, and in response to that disturbance, the controller takes the action and brings the output again back to the desired value. This is the set point, desired value. I will mark it here. Desired value of what? Desired value of controlled variable, which is also called as set point. It can be shown here as well. So this line represents the set point. So taking the output from initial value to set point is tracking, and regulation is what? The output is already at set point, but it is disturbed due to some set point. It is deviated from the set point, so it is brought back to the set point, is called as the regulation. So this is the important terminology. And now let us move to the classification of control systems. We'll see briefly, and details will be discussed in the next class. Classification of control systems. So mainly the control systems are classified with two different perspectives. One is based upon input-output relationship. And these types of control systems are the general types of systems. So they are equally applicable to other systems. That is, the systems other than control systems as well. So what are they? One by one we'll see. So the first one is linear versus non-linear. So what is mean by linear? Linear system is that which satisfies the superposition theorem and law of homogeneity. If it does not, then the system is non-linear. We will not enter into those details in this lecture, but in the next lecture we will briefly see the different systems. What is linear, what is non-linear? The next one is time invariant versus time variant. So the system is said to be time invariant if its output-input relationship does not change with time. And if the output-input relationship changes with time, then it is a time-variant system. This entire course is dealing with the continuous time, linear time-invariant systems only. We will deal with linear time-invariant systems only. The system, those will be linear as well as time-invariant. The third type is causal versus non-causal. What is mean by causal? So a system is said to be causal if its output depends only on present and past values of input and not on the future. Now if the output depends also on future inputs, then the system becomes non-causal. And the control system can never be non-causal. Because for any system, if we require future values of inputs, that is not realistic. So non-causal systems are not physically realizable. Hence, control system must always be causal. Then stable versus unstable. what is stable system? So a system is said to be stable if it produces bounded output for every bounded input. What does it mean? It means that if you apply some bounded input, means which has the bounded magnitude, which is not infinite, if we apply such input to a system, and then if the system produces output which is also bounded, then the system is stable, otherwise the system is unstable. Now control system always must be stable. Unstable control system is not permissible. The next type is, further other types are also there, like static versus dynamic, invertible versus non-invertible, but those are the common types to every system, which are not more relevant to a control system, because control system is always a dynamic system and we don't have to analyze the invertibility, so we will not deal with those properties of system or those types of system. We will directly move to continuous time versus discrete time. So what is continuous time and what is discrete time? Continuous time system is a system in which all the variables are the function of continuous time. And in discrete system, one or more components in the system, involved in the system, are dealing with or are the function of the discrete time index. They are having the values only at certain sampling or some certain sampling instance, and their value will be zero for other time. So that is a discrete time. We are going to deal in this subject with continuous time systems only. So our focus will be on continuous time, linear, time invariant control systems. Next is single output, which is also called as CISO, versus MIMO. MIMO means multiple input, multiple output systems. So single input, single output system has only one input and one output, like this. There is only one input and there is only one output. Here is the temperature. In this case, there is only one input, inlet flow rate, and only one output is there, that is level inside the tank. But multiple input, multiple output systems are also there, and we are not going to deal with, in most of the cases, we are not going to deal with the MIMO systems. Our focus will be on the CISO systems. Next type is lumped parameter versus distributed parameter systems. What does it mean? Our focus will be on the lumped parameter. Lumped parameter system are the system, those can be represented using differential equation, ordinary differential equation. And the distributed parameter system are those which generally uses the partial differential equations. So our focus will be on the lumped parameter, but we are not going to discuss these types in detail. And finally, the deterministic versus stochastic or probabilistic. So deterministic system is the system in which the output is predictable and has repeatability, means it the same output appears again and again for the same input. Whereas stochastic system is that where the output cannot be predicted. A simple example of stochastic system can be, if you toss the coin, what will be the outcome? So it is having a random variables. So we will be dealing with the deterministic systems. So this was the types depending upon the input-output relationship. Similarly, there are certain types depending upon the control strategy. So many different types are there, but we will consider only main four which are of our interest. The number one is say manual versus automatic. Consider here that if a person is operating this valve, it becomes manual, but if this valve is operated by some mechanism automatically, it becomes automatic system. Then the second type is say open loop versus closed loop. We'll discuss this in detail in the next class. Third one is let us consider feedback versus feed forward. And the last one is, I won't mention it here because it is done here, tracking versus regulating. Even certain different several types are there, but these are the basic types, and this covers the complete terminology of the control system. What is our purpose? Our purpose is to keep the controlled variable at its desired value, that is set point, irrespective of set point changes and disturbances. That is our purpose. So in the due course we will see several methodologies to accomplish this. It is enough for now in this lecture. Let us meet again in the next class, where we will cover the concept of open and closed loop system, feedback and feed forward system, with their features, their comparison, and their real life example.